see smoking.
All right, so here we are at GitCon, and I have Mr. Glenn Fricker here. Hello, Glenn.
How's it going, Tony?
Tony King. That's right. I got a brand new name here at GitCon. If I got nothing else out of it, I got a new name, which actually makes sense. I prepared some questions for you.
Sure.
Would that be okay?
Absolutely.
Okay, cool.
Let's do this.
In true interview style, question number one is, and these are very, very serious questions, so I know sometimes you go the comedic route, so very, very serious. Ready? Very intense.
Okay.
Okay. Which you know I'm teeing up anything but intense with that kind of introduction.
Yes.
It's kind of one of those.
With anticipation.
It's kind of one of those. You're not going to believe this, and then you tell them, which means you're not going to believe it because it's all made up and phony. Okay, so here we go. Have you smashed any more Line 6 stuff lately?
Well,
you knew that was coming. Come on.
Besides dropping the wireless off my desk and snapping off the belt clip, no. I'd like to, though.
Why? Why?
Well, it's like, you know, stepping on an ant or something like that. There's just... No. I've got more respect for ants.
Dude, that's brutal. You know, I have to say, in their defense, they've been at the... You know, there's a lot of modeling companies out there. And I'm going to step back a little so you are blocking the sun for me, if that's okay.
Yep.
There's a lot of modeling, and this isn't on the question. This is just friendly conversation. There's a lot of modeling companies out there, and to their credit, they've been doing it from day one. They've really stuck true to their roots.
Sure.
They went on a little bit of a path in the past with Bogner and did the tube thing,
yeah.
But for the most part, they've really stayed very consistent with what they do from the beginning. And I think you even tried like Native and Helix and stuff like that.
Yeah, the Helix Native was okay.
Yeah.
I didn't really have any major issues with that.
Yeah. Do you see value in modeling at all?
Maybe if you go like super high-end modeling, like Axe FX and whatnot, but I mean, like, when it comes to digital, I'd rather just go with a Kemper.
You know, it's interesting. There seems to be religion between, and I'm going off the beaten path of my questions, but there seems to be kind of religion between Kemper and Axe FX. What are your thoughts one way or the other?
Religion's useless no matter which version of it is. It is.
Well, okay, so forget the religion analogy. Some people like Kemper, some people like Axe FX. Which side do you...
I gotta admit, I think the Kempers are a little bit truer to what it's attempting to emulate.
Mm-hmm.
So I gotta go with that route. Yeah, the Axe FXs are good, but I always hear, you know, every time there's a firmware update, no, this time it really sounds like a real amp. And they do that every single time there's a firmware update. And like, okay, well, when do we get to the point where that's actually true?
Mm. Would it be fair to say, in your opinion, and this is more of a question, even though I'm giving you a statement, that modeling just isn't quite the real thing, right?
Not yet, anyway.
Never really will be.
Well, I don't know about never will be. I mean, like, you know, I mean, like, we're going to get there eventually. That's the thing about technology. It's constantly evolving. Mm-hmm. I think it will get to a certain point. I think the Kemper is probably the best bet we've got at this point, though.
So, interestingly enough, I can't really comment one way or another because I don't think I've ever played a Kemper, and I don't think I've ever played an Axe FX.
Oh, there you go.
But I have played
That's
some
like
other...
I've never mic'd anything up with a blue mic before. There you go.
There you go. So there's always a time for something new.
Yeah.
But I think what most modeling amps lose in general is the feel. I used an analogy the other night on the live web stream. Do you ever go on one of those rides? It's a simulated roller coaster.
Sure.
Do you ever go on a real roller coaster? It's totally different, right?
Yeah.
And I think that's what modeling is. It may give you the experience, but it doesn't give you the feel.
Sure.
You know, that's kind of what I think anyway.
Okay.
All right. Second really serious question. Are you ready?
Sure.
Okay. Have you smashed any bass players lately?
Never smashed a bass player.
Who do you smash? Bass players, drummers?
No, I don't smash anybody.
What are some of your things about... Yeah, dude, you smash bass players, don't you?
Not physically.
But on your videos?
Okay, sure.
Talk to me about your bass players. Some of your isms.
There's just a big difference between, you know, bass players who are in your average garden variety basement band and, you know, real musicians who play bass.
Right.
There's definitely a line there. Unfortunately, I get the former more than the latter.
Hmm.
Or at least used to, anyway.
Right.
And the thing is, it's really universal for a lot of people. They run into the same issues where, you know, the bass is an afterthought and is usually picked up by the shitty guitar player.
Well, I hear you. And I have to say, all of that aside, here at GitCon, we've seen some pretty talented bass players.
Would Oh, hell yeah.
Really?
Like that guy right there.
Yeah, some rocking bands. All right. So, you recently took a question number three. You ready?
Yep.
All right. Do you like the questions so far?
Yep, sure.
Are you going to smash me in your video for giving you subpar questions?
Nope.
I'll be prepared for it if you do. Okay. Question number three. You recently took a look at Harley Benton 1x12 cabinets loaded with Celestion Vintage 30s.
Yes.
You have notoriously high standards for anything that isn't high standards and really seem to like the cab. Have you seen anything else from Harley Benton here that you've really liked?
Yeah, actually, their little Paul Reed Smith copy I thought was really nice. I'd love to have one of those guitars. Their 7-string fan fret really reminded me a lot of the Legator. I thought the neck was a little thick for my taste, a bit too much of a D-curve on that. Mm-hmm. But yeah, their Tele was great. The Tele was great. The PRS copy was great. The Les Paul copy was great. Yeah, so you know what? Serious bang for the buck guitars.
Okay.
I mean, like, shit, I remember some of the beginner guitars we had when we were kids back in the 80s, and they were absolute garbage.
Right.
And the Harley Benton stuff's actually some serious bang for the buck.
Cool. Well, those are all the questions I had for you. Is there anything you would like to talk about or maybe answer that I haven't specifically asked you here?
Oh, I don't know. when's your flight back, dude?
I actually have an 8 a.m. flight, but the shuttle's picking us up at me and a couple of other folks at 2-hour drive to Nuremberg, and then a 4-hour layover in Munich, which kind of sucks, but it is what it is.
Yeah, it's like my flight leaves at 2:30 in the afternoon, and I get like a 4-hour layover in Frankfurt, I think, or something like that, or a two-hour layover in Frankfurt, and a 4-hour layover in Toronto when I get there.
Wow, so you have three legs.
Yes. That's how I did it the first time. Well, the first leg's no big deal. I mean, like, it's only an hour between Toronto and Windsor, so
no big deal.
And it's a 4-hour drive if I were to do it by car, so it's about the same.
Gotcha.
So why not?
So did you have fun at GitCon?
I had a fantastic time at GitCon.
What was your favorite thing?
Just hanging out with everybody, meeting a whole bunch of YouTubers I've never really had a chance to hang out with. Yeah. This has been great because we've just been able to sit down and hang out.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and it's quiet. You know, we can go in the rooms and make noise, and it's quiet out in the main room, and it's absolutely fantastic. I just want to say extra special big thanks to Henning Pauly. Dude, you pulled off a miracle here, dude. Take a bow, man. You did a great job.
And I must say, for those tuning in, you know, Glenn and I were walking down to the concert hall the other day, and we were talking about, you know, what we like and what we dislike, and he made a comment to me. He was like, you know, I said I like nice people, right? Like, who doesn't like nice people? And he laughed. He goes, ha, 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 like, why do you like me? And I was like, dude, you're actually a nice guy, you know? And it's funny because...
Don't tell them that.
That's the thing, you know, you come across so angry on camera, but you're a hell of a nice guy.
Well, it's your channel. I got to be nice.
There you go. So if this was your channel, what would you do differently?
Oh,
beep,
I don't...
Beep, beep, beep. Just kind of keep hitting the censor button.
Something to that effect, yes.
So you're keeping it PG for the
kiddies out there, yes.
There you go. Well, all good right. stuff. All Glenn, right. It was really nice hanging well, out with
pleasure,
you.
My pleasure, man. It's great hanging out with you. It's great bumping into the airport in Nuremberg, too.
That's like, right.
Dude, what are you doing? Let's go.
That's right. So I enjoy your videos. I'm always, you know, curious to see what you're going to put a sledgehammer to next. Certainly makes for quality entertainment.
Absolutely.
And
that's the idea.
Thanks for the
Everybody thinks it's entertaining, but the guys at Line 6. No, I can't please everybody.
Well, you know, it's tough. You know, that's like taking a poster of me and like smashing it with sledgehammer and be like, ah, dude, did you see the video? I'd be like, yeah, it was a little rough, dude. Yeah, it's hard to please people with that kind of thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then again, you know what? Truthfully, when you look beyond that, I think there was some entertainment effect. I think you were shooting for some entertainment effect there as well, right?
And some honesty.
Oh, stop. I don't believe you. I don't believe it. I'm not buying it.
Okay.
Dude, you recreated a scene from a movie.
Yeah, we did.
A good movie.
Yeah.
But you did.
True. Okay.
Anyway, man, lots of fun, and thanks for hanging.
All right, man. Take it easy.
Later.
See ya.
the Fricker.
How's it going?
How you doing, man?
Not bad. Just struggling to get an edit finished, that's all.
What was your favorite thing about the show?
Just hanging out with everybody. Yeah. I think everybody's been amazing at this. Like, there's a lot of familiar friends like you guys and whatnot, you know, you and Pixie and Rob and that kind of thing, but there's a lot of really cool new people here that I, a lot of guys from this side of the pond that I might not have had a chance to meet before. So it's been really great.
I have to tell you, we have a lot in common because I would have said the same thing. It was about the people.
Hang. This has been great. Just everybody's been awesome here. It's been great, and I'm really looking forward to next year's.
Did you want to smash anything with a sledgehammer?
No.
No?
Not here. I was talking to one of the helpers, though. He might bring something that we can sledgehammer.
So if there was one thing you could hit with the sledgehammer, what would it be?
It's not here.
Wow, okay.
No, this has been great.
There it is. Good positive stuff.
I don't know. Maybe Frank Fleckelstein over there. Yeah, let's hit him with a sledgehammer.
Hello? There it is.
Hello.
If he only
knew. Yeah, everybody here has been really great, except for Frank.
So...
Everybody's doing what?
Everybody here's been really great, except for Frank.
It's a sledgehammer story.
Yeah.
Say hi, Frank.
Hi. What's up?
Frank's awesome. I'm just pulling your leg.
There it is. Later.